Hello, welcome to the lecture. In this lecture, we will be finding out the gain margin and phase margin of a given system mathematically. The past few classes we have discussed on finding gain margin and phase margin of a system using Bode plot, polar plot. Here we are going to use mathematical equations to find out the gain margin and phase margin. Welcome to the lecture. Before going to the lecture, let us again refresh what is a gain crossover frequency. Gain crossover frequency is the frequency at which the magnitude of g of j omega, h of j omega, that is magnitude. The symbol is this is the sign of magnitude, right? Symbol for magnitude is 1. The frequency at which magnitude becomes 1 is called gain crossover frequency. Then what is phase crossover frequency? The frequency at which the phase angle is 180 degree. I can represent by angle sign or symbol phi. All represents phase angle. The frequency at which it becomes is called 180 degree or minus 180 degree is called phase crossover frequency, omega pc. Then gain margin. Gain margin is 1 by magnitude at phase crossover frequency. Remember, to find gain margin, first we have to identify phase crossover frequency, then find out the magnitude, then you have to do 1 by magnitude. Thereby you will get the gain margin. This gain margin can be also said in decibel, right? So what is decibel? We have to take 20 log gain margin. Okay, gain margin is this value, 1 by magnitude at omega pc. Then if you put 20 log and put that value 1 by magnitude at omega pc, we will get the answer in decibel. Remember, gain is said in polar plot by this expression, right? 1 by the magnitude only. Okay. Right, gain margin in Bode plot is this term. Gain margin in polar plot is this term. Gain margin in Bode plot is in decibel. 20 log gain margin. Okay, understand the difference, right? If you are using Bode plot, we have to take gain margin in decibel. If you are using polar plot or Nyquist plot, we have to take gain margin in this way. Okay, fine. Then what about phase margin? Phase margin is 180 degree plus angle at omega gc. Right. So, to find phase margin, first we have to identify what is the gain crossover frequency. At that frequency, find out angle, then add with 180 degree, you will get phase margin. Okay, right. Now, let us look at a simple polar graph. I have drawn here. Okay, yes, quick refreshment, we are seeing these things, right? But anyhow, we are going to see the mathematical techniques only. But you have to still know what is the graphical procedure behind it. Okay, so this is a polar plot. We know the concentric circles indicates the magnitude, right? If we have some circles like this, it indicates the magnitude, right? So this is the unit circle. Unit circle means magnitude is 1. I have mentioned the unit circle where the magnitude is 1. Then this is the real axis, imaginary axis, negative real axis and negative imaginary axis. Based on your angles, I can say this is 0 degree, 90, 180 degree, 270 degree, back to 0 degree or 360 degree. Okay, fine. Now, see, this red line is your polar plot. Okay, this red line is your polar plot. That is, I am plotting magnitude and omega, right? Magnitude and omega. The point at which the polar plot is cutting unit circle. Okay, this point it is cutting, this red line is the polar plot. It is cutting the unit circle at this point. What I have said, the frequency at which the magnitude cuts magnitude becomes 1 is called gain crossover frequency. So the corresponding frequency is called, the frequency corresponding to this point is called gain crossover frequency, the where the magnitude is 1. Okay, the corresponding phase angle, right? We know the radial lines are the phase angle in a polar plot. I have explained clearly these things in a separate video lecture, right? You can watch that too. Okay, so if this is omega gc, the angle corresponding to this line is your phi gc. Okay, right. Now coming here, now we are going to see at what frequency it cuts the 180 degree. Okay, so this is your polar plot. It is cutting this is the angle of 180 degree. It is cutting at this point, right? The frequency to that point is your phase crossover frequency. The frequency at which the g of j omega, h of j omega is becoming one angle of j of j omega, h of j omega or phi is becoming 180 degree or minus 180 degree is called phase crossover frequency. The corresponding frequency is phase crossover frequency, where the phase is 180 and the magnitude is this blue line. This blue line indicates the magnitude. Okay, from here to here, the magnitude is given as at omega pc. Okay, right. Some important points you have to note. When the polar plot or Nyquist plot cuts the negative real axis, that corresponding omega is omega pc. Right, you can see here. See, it is cutting the, this is your negative real axis. This is real, this entire thing is real axis. This is positive real axis. This is negative real axis. Where it is cutting the negative real axis, this corresponding omega is called omega pc. Okay, to find out omega pc, what we do, we make the imaginary part is zero. Okay, for this entire line, the imaginary part is zero, right? Imaginary part is positive this side, imaginary part is negative this side. Exactly on this line, imaginary part is zero. Okay, to find omega pc, we will equate imaginary part as zero. That's the first point to note. Second point is, when the polar plot or Nyquist plot cuts the unit magnitude circle, the corresponding omega is omega gc, right? So this is the unit circle. The point at which it is cutting is, this point is called omega gc. Okay, right. Okay, these are some essential things you should know. Now we will also see about for a stable system how the plot will be. Okay, the same thing I have drawn. This is the unit circle. This is my polar plot. Okay, let us observe that it is cutting here, right? It is cutting the negative real axis. So this point is omega pc, phase crossover frequency, and the corresponding phase angle is 180 degree. The corresponding magnitude is this. This is the value of this dark green line, right? Okay, this line. This is the magnitude at omega pc. Okay, then how to find omega gc? Omega gc is the point where it cuts the unit circle, right? This point is omega gc, where the magnitude is 1. The corresponding phase angle, okay, the corresponding phase angle, right? I have to put the arrow, right? Corresponding phase angle is the phi gc. Okay, right. Now let us see, for a stable system, the magnitude at omega pc should be less than 1. Okay, this magnitude should be less than 1. We know this circle magnitude is 1. So this is definitely, this dark green line is less than 1. So the gain margin is 1 by magnitude at omega pc. Okay, the denominator term is less than 1. So 1 by less than 1, the answer is greater than 1. Okay, next, for phase margin, we know the definition is 180 degree plus 5 gc. This 5 gc is between 0 to minus 180 degree. It will be between the 0 to minus 180 degree, right? So 180, so this term is definitely less than minus 180. So definitely we'll get the phase margin as positive. Okay, so for a system to be stable, the gain margin should be greater than 1. The phase margin should be positive. This is the condition for a stable system. Okay. For a system to be stable, it should be greater than 1 and phase margin should be positive, right? This is how the polar graph will look like, right? Okay, for a stable system. Next, we'll look for an unstable system, right? For an unstable system, I have drawn is roughly a polar plot, right? This is a unit circle. This is your polar plot, right? Red line is the polar plot. Okay, the point at which it cuts the negative real axis is your omega pc, where the phase angle is 180 degree. This dark green is the magnitude. The magnitude is given as magnitude at omega pc. Okay, right. If you observe this, this is unit circle. So this is greater than 1. Okay, so the magnitude is greater than 1 means gain margin is definitely 1 by greater than 1 is less than 1. Okay, so that is the condition for unstable system. Then find out the gain crossover frequency. The frequency at which, this is my polar plot, where it is cutting 1. This entire circle is unit circle. This plot is cutting 1 at this point, right? That point is called magnitude 1. Okay, that corresponding frequency is your omega gc. Right, omega gc. The corresponding magnitude is 1. So what is the phase angle from here to here? The phase angle is 5 gc. Of course, you can see here, this line, this is 0 degree, this is minus 90 degree, this is minus 180 degree, this is minus 270 degree. Okay, so this point is definitely greater than minus 180 degree. So 180 less than, okay, 180, it's it is less than minus 180 degree. For example, I'm taking this angle is minus 210, so the phase angle is negative, phase margin is negative. So for an unstable system, the condition for stability is, condition for unstability is, not stable is, the gain margin is less than 1 and the phase margin should be negative. Okay, then what about the marginally stable system? The last case, it is between these two. Okay, marginally stable system, stable system we said greater than 1 gain margin. For unstable system, gain margin is less than 1. For marginally stable, gain margin is equal to 1 and phase margin is equal to 0 degree. This is the condition for marginally stable system. Okay, right. So if you look at it, it will be like this. I can draw like that. This is an unit circle, means we'll take some other color. It will be like this, right? So what is the magnitude? This is 1. Okay, at what angle it is cutting? Minus 180. This is how the polar plot will be there for an marginally stable system. 0 degree, 180 degree, minus 90 degree, minus 270 degree. Okay, right. That is, between stable and unstable is called marginally stable. For stable, gain margin is greater than 1. For unstable, it is less than 1. So it is at 1, exactly at 1, it is marginally stable. Okay, right. Similarly, for phase margin, for stable system is positive. For unstable system, it is negative. So for marginally stable system, it is 0. Fine. Now, our objective is to do mathematically, right? Here only we are coming into the main part of the lecture. We are not worried about the plots. Anyhow, for refreshment, I explain those things. Okay. Now you see, an open loop transfer function is given. They are asking gain crossover, phase crossover, gain margin, phase margin. Okay, and also asking comment on stability. First thing, I am going to find the sinusoidal transfer function or sinusoidal frequency response. So in place of S, I put j omega. So multiplying inside, I got this term, real part plus imaginary part. Okay, I have already said in note 1, to find the phase crossover frequency, you can see here, to find the phase crossover frequency, what I should do? It where the polar plot cuts the negative real axis. I will equate the negative real axis, means imaginary part is 0. Okay, so if you look here, to find the phase crossover frequency, this is my imaginary part, I will equate it to 0. When I equate that term to 0, I bring 2 omega cube to the right side, then I see, I missed it out, right? It will be like, this is still cube, right? Okay, so cube, this will get cancelled, so omega equal to 1 by root 2. The corresponding frequency is called phase crossover frequency, the frequency obtained by equating the imaginary part to 0. Okay, equating, I can write it here like, equating imaginary part equal to 0, I will get the phase crossover frequency. Then I will find out the gain margin. What is gain margin? 1 by magnitude. What is magnitude? This term is the magnitude for this term. This is real part, this is imaginary part. So square root of real part square plus imaginary part square, and I will substitute the omega g, omega pc value, that is by 1 by root 2 here, I will get the answer as 1.5. Okay, suppose they are asking what is the gain margin in decibel, means I mentioned is GB. This is gain margin. Gain margin in decibel means I will take 20 log of the gain margin. 20 log 1.5, this is 3.5 dB. Okay, so we have found out the phase crossover frequency by equating the imaginary part of the transfer function to 0, then put it in the magnitude, and I take 1 by magnitude. At phase crossover frequency, I will get the gain margin. Suppose gain margin in decibel means I will take 20 log gain margin. Okay, right. Then if you are going to find gain crossover and phase margin, okay, so this is your transfer frequency response. So this is the magnitude, right? Magnitude I am taking and this is the phase angle. For so magnitude control very simple now. For 1 by j omega, the magnitude is 1 j omega, the magnitude is omega. 1 plus j omega, it is square root of 1 plus omega square. Then for this, the magnitude is this real part, this is imaginary part. So real part square plus 2 omega square whole square. Phase angle for 1 by j omega, it is minus 90. For then for 1 plus j omega, it is plus tan inverse of omega. Since in denominator I put the minus sign, for that is tan inverse of 2 omega by 1. Since denominator I put the minus sign. Okay, magnitude and phase. Now for the gain crossover frequency, the magnitude should be equal to 1, right? So I got this magnitude, right? I put it here, this is equal to 1. Then using trial and error method, I can easily find out what is omega gc. Okay, take your calculator, you can put various values, right? In a calculator we have a function called calc, okay, and we have some alphabets. Next to shift there is an alphabet key is there. By pressing alphabet you can enter some variables names like a, b, c, d. Okay, here in place of omega c I enter a, then I press calc, then if I say equal to, the value can be computed for various values of omega gc, right? So I at 0.57 I found out the value, this value should be equal to 1. So that is the trial and error method. You have to use scientific calculator. The two you have to use this calc function. Okay, you have to know how to operate these things. Calc function in the calculator, right? Easily you can find out. Okay, then we know. Okay, now we know what is the phase margin. Phase margin definition is 180 degree plus phi gc. This is my phi. So what is phi gc? In place of omega, I will be putting omega gc. We already find what is omega gc, put those values, we get phi gc is minus 168. So phase margin is 180 minus 168 is equal to 12 degree. So on seeing these things, we can say gain margin for the system is 3.5 dB, phase margin is 12 dB, both are positive. Gain margin, decibel means it is in 12 dB, sorry 3.5 dB, 3.5 dB. Phase margin 12 degree. So the system is stable system. Okay. Let's move to the next problem. Next problem is an design problem, right? A transfer function is given. They are asking find the value of K so that gain margin is 6 dB. And they are also asking find the value of K so that the phase margin is 40 degree. Okay. Now we observe closely. This is a design problem, right? Why I say it's a design problem? It's a design problem because they have given the conditions, right? They have given the conditions such that gain margin is 6 dB, phase margin is 40 dB. They are asking what is the value of K. They are asking design the value of K. Okay, so for this problem, these are very important problems, right? Designing. Okay, this also we can do mathematically. Let's see how we are doing. Okay, we are going to find the frequency response or sinusoidal transfer function. In place of S, I am putting j omega, then I am multiplying. So real part plus imaginary part, taking j outside. Okay, this just you multiply j omega with this term, then entire term is multiplied with this term, then take j part outside. Okay, we get these things, right? Next, what is omega pc? Okay. What is omega pc? Is the phase crossover frequency. How to find? Equate, already we have seen, equate the imaginary part to 0. This is the imaginary part, equate it to 0, I get omega pc equal to square root of 10. Now what is gain margin? 1 by magnitude. So 1 divided by k, what is the magnitude of this term? Square root of minus 1.1 omega square whole square. See, since we are doing square, I ignore the minus sign, right? Whole square means minus vanishes. Plus omega minus 0.1 omega cube whole square. What frequency? Omega pc. Now you take this omega pc, put it here, we will get 1 by k by 11. This term becomes, so on solving it, 11. So gain margin is 11 by k. Okay, but observe in the problem, what is given? It is given that gain margin is 6 dB is given, right? So it is gain margin decibel scale it is given. So what I have to do? I have to express this gain in decibel. gain margin in decibel. So 20 log gain margin, that is 20 log 11 by k. Gain margin is 11 by k. This is 20 log 11 by k. In the question, it is given as equal to 60 dB. This is given. Then bring 20 to right side. So 6 by 20 becomes 3 by 10. So log means base 10. So I take anti-log on both sides. So this becomes 11 by k equal to 10 power 3 by 10 is 0.3. Okay, right? This anti-log operation is very important. Okay, if I take anti-log, this logarithm on left side vanishes. In the right side, it becomes 10 power. So 10 power 0.3 is 2. So 11 by k equal to 2. So k equal to 5.5. Okay. Now that's the answer, right? So if I keep k as 5.5, I will get gain margin as 60 dB. Okay. Now we move to the next problem. They are asking B part of the problem. They are asking k. Given the phase margin is 40 degree. Okay, so this is the frequency response in place of phase attribute j omega. Then this is the magnitude. Okay, then this is the phase angle. Okay, now what is phase margin? 180 degree plus phase angle at omega gc. This is the definition for phase margin. What is given? Phase margin is 40 degree. So 40 degree is equal to 180 degree minus, what is this? Phi. This is my phi. Phi gc means in place of omega, I can put omega gc. Okay, this is the expression I get. So bring this term, put it here. I put it here, right? Okay, tan inverse of, just I'm substituting omega gc, phi at omega gc here. Okay, now you take tan terms to the left side, 40 to the left right side. So 180 minus 90 minus 40 becomes 50. These two terms come to the left side. So tan inverse of plus tan inverse equal to 50 I'm getting. There is an ready-made formula, tan A plus B is equal to tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. Okay. So what I am doing is, I am assuming that this is my A, this is my B. Okay. So if I take tan on both sides, this becomes tan A plus B equal to tan 50. Okay. Tan A plus B is tan of A plus tan B, this is by B, divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. Okay, so tan inverse gets cancelled out, so it becomes 0.1 omega gc plus tan cancelled out, so it becomes omega gc. 1 minus tan inverse gets cancelled out, 0.1 omega gc, tan inverse gets cancelled out, omega gc equal to tan 50 is 1.92. okay, so here we get an quadratic expression. And use your calculator to find out omega gc, or you can use the formula, right? Minus b plus r minus square root, you can use that also. We get two values of omega gc. One we are getting as negative, another we are getting as positive. We know the frequency can be only be positive, so this is the valid gain crossover frequency. This is invalid, right? This is not valid since it is negative. Okay, now we know at gain crossover frequency the magnitude is 1. So what is the magnitude? If you look at the previous slide, this is the magnitude. Okay, at gain crossover frequency, what I can put in place of omega, I will put omega gc, that is equal to 1. Okay, equal to 1. So bring this term to the right side. I know what is omega gc is 0.98. on substituting and solving, you get as k as 1.378. So this is the design problem. If k is 1.378, what is the phase margin? Phase margin is 40 degree. Or I can say, if the phase margin is 40 degree, k should be 1.378. Okay. Next. This problem is for your practice, right? I hope I have not written everything in the board. Just I have written some hints. You proceed on your own. Pause the video. Take notes. Try to check whether you are able to solve. Problems, analytical papers like control system can be mastered only by practice. Just by watching the video will not help you in any way, right? Watch the video, solve the problems. Okay, right. G of S is given. They are given determine K, gain margin is 20 dB. In the second part of the problem, determine K for the phase margin is 40 degree, right? First thing, find the transfer function or find the frequency response. In place of S, you put J omega, we get an expression. Then to find omega pc, what you have to do? Equate the imaginary part. So omega pc you should be getting as this is omega pc, you should be getting as 10. You have to solve, right? You should get answer 10, right? Then 1 by magnitude, if you solve this, gain margin should be 25 by k you will be getting, right? But in the question it is given as 20 dB. So what you are doing, 20 log gain margin, that is 20 log 25 by k is equal to 20 dB. 20 dB is given, right? So on solving k you should get as 2.5. please try to solve these problems on your own, okay? Then only you can master the subject, okay? Right, okay, let me see how you are trying. If you have doubts, put it in the comment section. I hope you can solve the simple elementary mathematical steps. Okay, next, they are given find the k when the phase margin is 40 degree, right? I know what is the phase margin is 40 degree, so 5 gc I filled out, omega gc. Now solve for omega gc. Okay, similarly bring 40 this side, tan terms to the right side, take tan a plus b formula as you worked out in the last problem, find out omega c. That omega c should be equal to omega gc. Omega gc should be equal to 4. Now we know at gain crossover frequency magnitude is 1. Put the magnitude value, that is equal to 1. Okay, solve for k. K should be equal to 5.2. okay, give a try whether you are able to find out omega gc and k. This problem please try on your own, practice. Okay, right, next. I hope many of you would have got a striking question. Sir, then what is the problem? I have been working with the Bode plot, polar plot to find the gain margin, phase margin, designing something. I am adjusting the values of k. But these questions, you just used mathematical concept to mathematical way of getting the gain margin, phase margin, and designing also possible. Then what is the need for this plot? Okay, the question would be like, if you're able to find these things, then what is the need for the plot? The answer is very simple. Mathematically, it is easy for the first order and second order system. Okay, it is very easy to find by mathematical procedure to find the gain margin and phase margin for a first order and second order system. It is very, very easy, and even for third order, but with only one open loop pole at the origin, similar to your last problem, right? Like if I say something like k divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2, this can be solved mathematically, right? But suppose if it is like k divided by s square into s plus 2 into s plus 3. Okay, look at this. There is two pole at the origin. This is very difficult to solve mathematically. And one more thing, if the expression is like k into s plus 1 divided by s into s plus 2 into s plus 3. Okay. Here we have the zeros. Okay, no open loop zero. If you have zero, you should have one open loop pole origin and no open loop zero only. Even for third order also we can solve. Okay, this is okay, I can solve this, but these two unable to solve mathematically or difficult to solve mathematically. So what is the conclusion I can make is, for a first order and second order system, and even for a third order system, for these two conditions I can go for mathematical procedure. But for a higher order system, mathematical equation fails. Or mathematical equations, in the sense, mathematical, it can be like mathematical procedure fails or become very difficult. Okay, that's the reason. Hope you enjoyed the class. Thanks for listening. Any doubts, please put in the comment section. Do subscribe the channel. Lot more videos are coming in this on engineering topics. Please share with your friends. Thanks for listening. Happy learning.